Faithful, I would be for. Victory is won. Even death's cold wave, I will not flee. Since thou through Jordan leadest me.
Just as Jesus Christ said, when he said, in the days of the coming of the Son of Man, will he find the faith when he comes? Amen.
Amen.
He says the love of many will wax cold.
Amen.
Amen. Because there are challenges. Because when you come into worship, when you start it, it's fine. Because the devil hasn't come close to you. You hear him from afar off. But now he's going to start noticing you, and he's going to bring his battle.
Okay.
Sometimes you wouldn't want to go to the service, and you'll try finding yourself alone, not knowing why.
Amen.
When they try to talk with you, you just be in a different condition, all anger. It's a battle. It's a battle to the Lord. It takes God's grace that we may stay happy. God bless you. I see Sister Thabang at the back. God bless you. And even some who are not noticing.
Amen.
God bless you. God
bless you.
So we're going to read some scripture. Invite the Lord in prayer.
Amen. God bless you. Before
we read, let us bow our heads.
Amen. Modimo a rena go sia o le ba bona motlodi wa le go tsena le fase. Di bitse le mmatla la Kriste Jesu re a le go go sia re le. Ke re la ba modimo ka sa tsile ga pe go wena. Modimo ka ka go ikokobetsa le go nyatsa go pela mo ga wa ga go le se ba le. Ba tla nna le ba le ka ile di pelo ka mo ka modimo le ka go si. Re di ja fa pa pa ka o tsama wena. Go si mo file tshepiso me a o tlo mo se o tshepiso jeng. O la ga ba ba bedi go ba ra ba go pa le dina ga o tsama bona mo ga ga mo. Blessed be
Let us read in the book of 2 Peter chapter 1.
2 Peter chapter 1, from verse 15 to verse 21.
2 Peter 1 from 15 to 21.
Amen. Alright, let me brother Sono no it's like a valle on my brother Kaka Sokua and then Baba will come over a money by the Jalini.
Moreover, I will endeavor that ye may be able after my decrease to have these things always in remembrance. For we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received from God the Father honor and glory when there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory. This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. And this voice which came from heaven we heard when we were with him in the holy mount. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well, that ye take heed as unto a light that shineth in a dark place until the day dawn, and the day star arise in your hearts. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
So,
in the time that we have, let us talk a little bit here. We're continuing with our message here at home. Our series on the climax of prophecy.
Amen.
Amen.
Today, like God is his own interpreter.
Today, we're talking about God is his own interpreter.
Amen.
Amen.
There's
a title you might be familiar with. Brother Branham preached on it.
So we
are going to talk about it.
Amen.
To see what the servant of God was saying. Just as you see, it's two of us here in front. It means there's one language that is coming out. And because it is not all who hear that language, then it is needed that one bring forth an interpretation of what has been said. In actual fact, an interpreter is one to bring the message to them that are listening.
Amen.
Amen. We begin to realize God is speaking, but
they
think God himself, he is his own interpreter.
Amen.
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 So he takes this word and he makes it audible. So there's two actions from God in this case. He first speaks the word and it goes to the people.
Then
and then he comes back and interprets the same word. In the beginning, when he says, let the world be, it was his word. No one knew what the world was. There was no world before. Him being God, he took that very same word he had spoken and he formed the world. When he was forming the world, that is when he was interpreting his word. Because
Amen.
God, his word, is a creating word. It's not communicating. It's not the same as just you communicating with another. When the word of God has been spoken, it has an action behind it. And the Bible says the word of God does not go forth and come back having been vain. It goes forth to do a work.
Amen.
It's not just
Amen.
To entertain. When it has gone forth, it has to do what it went
Amen.
Forth to do.
Amen.
Amen. So God speaks it, and he's the one who makes it to do that thing which he's supposed to do.
Amen.
Amen.
Now
Peter here, when he's talking, he says, brethren, I'd like you to realize that we are not following fables.
Amen.
Amen. Because a fable It's something that's there in communication. It could be nice in the ears, but it's not there. It only exists in that story of the one who's speaking it.
Amen.
You won't find it anywhere else. It's a fable, that thing. You may listen to it, but it has no effect. It doesn't do anything. Now the word of God is not just to be spoken and it ends there. It has a destination. So it's not a fable.
Amen.
Amen. Now Jesus Christ in his time, we find that people knew the word as the scriptures and the law. But that was the first part. An interpreter was then needed.
Amen.
Amen.
Because
you hear the Bible says the word of God
it
is of no private interpretation. It means there needs to be an interpreter. But the God who has spoken it,
he
is the one who interprets. To make it to bring forth that which he has spoken. Now when Jesus Christ was on earth, he found people worshipping. Worshipping and being satisfied. And he says, you are unfortunate, you Pharisees, because you cannot see what God is saying. They asked him that, you know, these things that you're doing, because they saw that there were things that he was doing. Now they're asking him, why are you doing these things in this way? He says, go into the scriptures and search in there.
And
in them you think you have eternal life. Those scriptures testify of me. So Jesus Christ was the interpretation of the scriptures they were reading. Now God's interpretation is not just a word of communication. It's a
happening.
When God has spoken something, what follows that spoken word is a making forth or happening of that word. When the Bible says everyone who believes will be saved, what follows that word is not when pastors are speaking, it's when people are being saved. And it's God who gave the promise who's going to save these people. Do you get it, brethren? So when Jesus Christ was sending them to the scriptures, he was telling them, look at me.
Amen.
See how I was born. Look at the ministry that I have. And the things that are happening in this ministry. You will find them in your scriptures. Those very scriptures that you have. Saying that you have eternal life in them. They are talking of me. He was trying to show them that the scriptures.
I know what it's
not just explanations. It is life eternal.
In action.
That is in action.
Right. Amen.
Eternal life.
Right.
John chapter 1. Says he who was in the beginning is the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God. He was the one who created all things. And the word. In the word was life.
Amen.
In other words, this life, in this word, the word does not go alone, just being preached. It comes
Amen.
With life. And when the life of this word is made visible, it is a light unto Christ.
Amen.
When God has spoken a matter,
wana mudimo a gona go tseba taba yeo ke nnete ba se nnete.
A child of God cannot discern whether that is true or not.
Go tla bona bophelo bo bo letse lentjwe leo.
Until the life that spoke that word.
Go tsiya lentjwe leo.
Comes and takes this word and brings it to
action. Le lentjwe le ba bophelo.
And when that word is coming and becoming life.
Motho a lebelelang se bophelo bo.
The one who's looking at that life.
O gona o tsebere go diragala fa.
Can be able to understand what is going on there.
Just a little fasting.
When Jesus Christ was on earth,
Bibili bolela hore ba ile ba ba mutsha ba re kwena ma.
The Bible says they asked him, who are you?
Go ke tlhalosa.
Just please explain yourself.
Ba re ga ka ntse re rape.
You are confusing us and we are worshiping you.
Marega ba ile ba lebella mangwele ka mo Jesu aba abule tsinga hona.
Amen. Look at the scriptures, the way Jesus Christ
talked. E ba to hoetsa mo mangwalo a bona.
They would have seen that in their scriptures.
A re kharebe tloima.
The Bible said that a virgin shall conceive.
Bela a hone ka mo go ka itlhalosa mo.
Now there's no way you can explain that.
Ino ba re kharebe ya ona yini.
It's just for the virgin to conceive.
He kharebe yo ima.
When the virgin conceives.
The interpretation.
That is interpretation.
Go mo di mo tlatsela sa se boletse.
Meaning God is vindicating that.
Go dira se pitle mo batho.
Making it to yeah, come yeah, to the people.
Bela ge batho ba lebelela.
Now when the people look,
ba so ni ba khone go bona kharebele yimile.
They must be able to see that that virgin has conceived.
Ke tlhaloso ya lentjwe lela.
It is an interpretation of that word.
Le tsara bana ba
mutimi.
Ba ge lentjwe la modimo le tswelela.
Now when the word of God has come forth,
mo metlha ya Jesus Christ.
In the days of Jesus Christ.
Gore bebele ka metlha ge lentjwe lela le thoma bophelo ba lentjwe.
The Bible says that the life of that word.
Gore ka mantjwe mo ge lentjwe lela le thoma go bona ga lit. A ke re selo sa ophela ke selo sa o move.
We know that something that is alive is something that moves around.
Bele ge bo lentjulela le thoma go bonala le apere nama le sepila.
Now when that word is made to dwell in flesh and we can see it walking,
ke yona ntho dira re kgone go bona.
That is the thing that makes us to be able to see.
Ka baby there bo philo ba lentju,
because the Bible says the life of the word
is on us yetja,
is the light.
Gore le mantjwa ka bolelwa,
you know, if words can be spoken,
wa sebele action ye modima e dira,
and there's no action that God takes,
then re kgone go bona re go dira galang.
Then we're not able to see what God is doing.
Mara modima ka bolela taba,
but if God speaks
I khatela,
and then he vindicates it,
then re hatse wa rumo,
then we know that he's there.
Ke ka mo khotswa ka ona modimo go ka,
that is how we know where God is.
Amen.
Amen.
Re yena ke interpreter,
if he himself interprets.
Gale botata go manchu ka manchi.
Now the problem is that there are a lot of words.
O bala mo Bible.
When you read in the Bible,
profeto ke ke dinji.
There's many prophecies.
Sepicho ke ke dinji.
There's many promises.
And ka ba kala re batho ba tsatsebe.
And because people don't know.
Ba fofela mo mangwalo.
They just jump into the scripture.
Wa lo na bona ba yokwela go dira eng.
According to how they feel.
Mara ge ba abanya go tseba re modimo o ko kae.
And if they truly want to know where God is.
Ba sine ba bona lentjo.
They have to look at the word.
Le bo philo ba modimo bo le mo lona.
In which the life of God is in.
Mangwale ba le manchi.
There were many scriptures.
Fela mongwe go ya bona.
But in their time.
Ke bona ba tshepitse modimo o tlotla Emmanuel.
That is when they were promised that God will come as Emmanuel.
Ke lona le ngwe le modimo na le phethagala.
That is the word that God was bringing forth.
Ke seng ka re ya bolela.
Not because we're talking.
No, yena modimo.
No, God.
O latile garebe.
Went to a virgin.
Ammotsa ka lona lentjwe.
And told me about this word.
Or lentjwe le sonye le phele ke.
This word that must come to life is this.
Ene re morao a belegwa.
Now when this son was being born,
a dira dilo ka moka,
and he was doing all these.
Ka motsa se modimo.
To show that he is God.
Ba 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 mmolana.
And they actually killed him.
Ba ba kutsa na botse ke bolaelwa.
When he was asking, why are you killing me?
Ba re o bolaela re o re o le motho.
They are saying, they said that we are killing you because you being a man,
we itira modimo,
make it yourself to be
God. Mara Isaiah 7.
But Isaiah in chapter 7,
ere re filwe ngwana,
says we unto us a child.
Dine la gore Emmanuel.
His name is Emmanuel.
Re le tlatlulwa.
When you interpret that,
gore modimo ana le re.
It says God with us.
Le tswara. A se ene na ba buta ke nna modimo.
It's not him who was saying he was God.
No, ditiro tsa hae.
No, his work.
Di medi ba bontsha.
They were showing
gore ke ena modimo.
That he is God.
Ga ebe le bophelo.
Now it was the life.
Ba lentjo.
Of the word.
Go bona ga.
That was being made.
That
is what should have made them realize that word is here.
Amen.
Amen.
But amehla then tshwe e dira gala ya go tswa ka mangwalo.
Now many times when something scriptural happens,
ke bo pilo ba modimo bo itse o dira.
The life of God that is making it happen.
Ya re na le botlhata batho ba o tsebe na.
Now we have a problem of not knowing time.
Mo profeta re ba phila mo kurukara edle, kurwa phila ka ra mo ritwa ntjongwe sa lebe.
The prophet says they are living in edle. confusion.
Amen. When
we talk about a glare,
is where
they used to be light. You know, when you turn off the light,
your
eyes have an illusion of something. You still think that you can see,
and
eventually you just realize, no, there's no light. My eyes are playing games with
me. Light.
But now remember that light is life.
In him was
life. And that life was the light. Now, in the Bible, Jesus Christ says, go and be witnesses.
A witness is
someone
who
is present when something is
happening.
Right. Not someone who is there where something happened. Where there was an accident. And that person was not there.
Then the camera was no accident.
And then after some time, when the accident has happened,
but clearly,
when things have been cleared,
what
he comes.
Oh, no, 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 look good.
Exactly where there was
what
an accident, and he looks around.
Afterwards,
when they ask for a witness, he raises his hand.
He says,
"I have witnessed."
But why are the
they say, "Why are you a witness?"
He says, "I was there
where the accident
happened."
But it does not happen.
It does not happen.
He does not see anything. Things have happened
here
when he was not
here.
He just happened to come where things have happened.
The
word is
like that.
There is a promised word for a certain time.
And
if you're not there when that word is happening, and you come later, to come and dance where it was happening, you're not a witness.
That's right, amen.
It's the same way as if the day dawns.
I wonder what this is today.
You see, it's hot today.
Tomorrow,
if it rains tomorrow,
you won't be given that's home right.
By yesterday's sun.
Reality,
your reality is
that
rain. It's raining today.
Yes.
It was hot
yesterday.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Don't dispute that. But what affects
yeah.
you is not yesterday's heat. It's
today's
rain.
That's right.
Prophet
of
a painted fire.
The prophet usually talks right. about a painted fire. You know, people find a fire and then they make a picture, a painting of that fire. And then, you know, maybe even shooting a video of it. A big fire. And then when winter comes, you don't even buy a heater. You just play the video. You find the fire is blistering in that video. But that heat is not there. Because that thing is not alive. Now,
on that video,
the one who was taking the video, he was taking the video in warm
nice.
Because it was hot when he was taking that video.
Amen.
Amen. Now, when the word of God goes forth. Because the Bible says we're going to be witnesses. It's not just someone trying
amen.
To quote all scriptures.
Jesus
was here, children of God. And he was healing the sick.
So
those are quotations. But God today is not busy with Jairus' daughter.
But
those have passed. You won't see that
today.
It has passed. Now when you are believing in worship, looking at Jairus' daughter, then you are worshipping in a shadow.
Amen.
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 That's what a lot of religions are doing today. Where God is, the Bible says he spoke the word before. He prophesied. When Peter is speaking, he says, we're not following fables. We want to tell you that he has received glory. We were with him on a mountain. And we are witnesses of that. And we actually knew that this is what was spoken before. Now you where you are, you have a word of prophecy. A word that was from the beginning, there are words that the prophets have spoken. Jeremiah, Malachi. It was a saying of old.
Yeah.
Now we're waiting for the interpreter. Because there's one who speaks first,
then
there's an interpreter. Now because he's spoken
then,
we're waiting for the interpreter.
Amen,
now.
That's right.
Well, interpreter is a leader.
Now he is still
very
interpreter.
Well,
we're not just going to look at him at the things he said long ago. We're going to look for him on the things that he's bringing forth, manifesting. Now, what made the Pharisees to be unable to recognize
him?
They were sitting there with the law. When he was doing things, they said, no, 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 our fathers ate manna. What can you give us?
Then
when we were saying something, they said, no, Moses, you see, they had the word, but some of it is what God once did.
Today,
what he's doing now is what can
Amen.
Save them.
Right.
But what they are quoting, the old is where God long ago. Like that person who's looking at the fire in the video. Now, God is here interpreting his word. It means that a child of God today must search the scriptures. If they want God, they have to find what God is doing today. We're not saying things that haven't happened yet.
No,
God is in another day. We won't dispute that there is a Monday.
Only Tuesday.
There's a Tuesday. You know, all the days until Saturday. But today is not Saturday.
It's Sunday.
It's Sunday. You know, even whatever you can do, you know, saying it's a Saturday. Those who know, knowing they do not have work on Sunday, the shops are even closed. Because it's a Sunday. Today.
Amen.
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 Right.
But we won't dispute that there have been other days.
Because Monday, Tuesday,
because the testimony that Monday and Tuesday have been there is because we are here today on a Sunday.
Amen.
It is to show that those days have been there. And the same way with the words of prophecy. When Jesus Christ came, he found them holding the law of Moses.
But
when Moses was here, these people who were keeping the law, God was there forgiving their sins. In the time of Moses, God forgave sins. And there was a pillar of fire that walked with them. Those who were following Moses' law. Now the time of the law has passed. Now the time of Jesus has come.
Pillar of fire.
The pillar of fire is not with the priest. It is
only
Jesus Christ. Who John says, I have seen only
one.
Now they're sitting there in history with this law, because it's now no more in power. They are being attacked by the devil holding the law. The law that they say they have, because its day is not as passed. Inside that law, the Bible says, don't kill. That word which they have. But if another man does something they do not like, to show that the law that they have is not effectual, they say, let's kill him. It's not something that has happened quickly. It was a plan. Because they were able to pay someone.
or
Because in Dima by the way today.
Because what God is asking of you today,
I protect
what
today.
God is protecting today. If you took the ark, when the time it was with in power, God was working in that time. God will punish you.
That ark.
If you touch that ark.
But
when the days of the ark have passed, God leaves the ark. Now, if you start now, you camping the ark. You are going to where they used to be a celebration. Now you'll be dancing alone. They've danced and they've passed. You've seen the video. You're saying they were here. Come there dancing.
People
will be looking at you,
saying
this person is here. But yesterday when there was an event, a celebration, people were dancing. It was good. It was something that was worth looking at. You see that? Now, what killed the people of Jesus Christ? They didn't know that God was his own interpreter. When he has spoken it, don't just
Amen.
Stay in the prophecy. Look at them. And then check
Amen.
Which one in your time is being interpreted. That is where you will see God.
Amen.
Amen.
That is
where God is.
Amen.
Because that's where
Hallelujah.
He's doing his action.
Amen.
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 Now, that's what a lot of religions have today. A lot of people following religions. In the time of Martin Luther, he was talking about justification. You know, just being believing that your sins have been forgiven. And just by believing, God came in power. If you can hear the miracles that were performed by Martin Luther, under justification.
Today,
there
are
certain religions preaching justification. They don't even have the guts. To lay
yeah.
hands on
they won't even start it.
By the Wesley.
John Wesley.
When John Wesley.
Tamo,
when he came.
Sanctification.
He was preaching
right.
Sanctification.
Justification.
So he took the justification. When God was bringing power into it.
Sanctification.
And it grew and became sanctification. So to believe that God has forgiven you. And living a holy life.
Right.
With that,
John Wesley
was able to have a great revival.
That's right. Amen.
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 Today,
you won't hear saying there's an outreach done by Wesley.
Because
that thing which they have
used
to come around
today,
but today, they hold it and it doesn't have any power.
Right. Amen.
They are being destroyed even having that thing. Because
it's
not where God is today. An old believer, an old Pentecostal, used to have power.
Right?
When he said Jesus saves, he
means
Jesus
saves.
He used to live a whole life doing things correctly. Holding on at the matter of the gifts.
Amen.
When God was moving, and the age was changing, going to the time of the restoration of the world, having gifts alone, you will prophesy.
The next thing,
and then the next thing, the pastor says that half of the choir
has
been impregnated by him. What has he done? He was living in a shadow.
This clay,
when he's holding on to this clay, it's not able to give him warmth. It's not able to protect him. And when the devil comes, he'll just swing him the way he wants.
Yes.
All Pentecostals, when you read in the times of Brother Branham, he came to another meeting in Mishiwaka, and he found people prophesying. And he sat there and he listened. And he heard, these are really
true.
And the next time they called him, saying there was a man who introduced himself recently, saying he's a Baptist believer, and saying he's Branham. Let him come forward and preach. When he tried to refuse, but they asked, why are you refusing? Says, I'm not appropriately dressed. My trouser is a sack. Now I don't think they'll accept me like this. They told him, in this belief, we do not care about your clothes. We want the word. It is in that time
of the restoration of the gifts.
When the restoration of the word,
why never do the restoration of the gift?
Those who got the restoration of the gifts, they found you cannot preach without a suit.
Yeah.
Because the devil could do anything to them. Even the women's clothing started going higher.
Agro.
You see?
They
were showing their legs. Back then, the life that was being lived was the time of the day. You would not play games.
Amen.
When Martin Luther was here, no Roman would be
Roma.
He was able to stop Rome.
Amen.
Dead still.
That's right.
When Martin Luther passed,
Roma yalata batubale kamuka.
Rome went and got all those people, collected them and made them a denomination.
Exactly.
Now today,
batu.
There's a lot of religions everywhere. Now you ask yourself, which scripture is
that
which God has been interpreting? Because he is there. His focus is to take this word and bring it to life and bring it to the people. Hear me.
Sanctification.
If a person believes in sanctification, they're not wrong. But the problem is that if they continue, and God is moving towards the restoration of the gifts,
sanctification is
the sanctification loses its power.
Know your day and its message.
We have to understand this day, knowing your day and its message. If you stand at the place where a bus has passed, you'll eventually have to go back home. Your trip was in vain. It's just that
right.
You are there in excitement.
With
bags, telling all these people, at a certain time, We'll be getting to a certain location. Flying on another thing, going elsewhere. Now those are just tables. Because what is supposed to be has already left. You just left with dreams as a person. Now, with this word, if someone was at the matter of the gift, when God moves to the restoration of the word,
priority
is
high.
Your priority is the word. You're not saying the word that the gifts are
wrong. Sanctification wrong.
Not saying sanctification
is wrong. Justification wrong.
Not saying justification
or protection
is wrong. Saying the protection is now here.
Amen.
So I can't do more than
so you can't just now sit there and say I have the word.
I get it about this justification.
I don't care about justification. This word inside is carrying justification. Inside is carrying the gift. Inside is carrying sanctification.
Good. That's right.
It is a full, complete word.
Amen.
Amen.
Today,
now, we're saying there's a lot of religions. They are standing on something. But they know fully well in their hearts that we are being defeated here. Even the pastor will stand at the pulpit and say, you know, you are defeating me.
Amen.
I don't even know what to do with you anymore. Because what he's saying does not manifest because there's no life that is able to change him who is listening to it.
Yeah. Amen.
That is why a person will take this Bible and say he believes the word, take a lot of his time studying in Bible school.
Alright,
and when they come, they've been just studying shadows. Now when they try to come up with something, nothing comes together. Just ends up saying, pastor. A pastor can be a woman. Because what they have is not the same. The
original.
Now, when a person comes to the word, to the true word, the Bible says that their conscience is awakened. There are certain things you cannot do. Because your conscience will be telling you without any preachers.
Or more wrong in
what you're doing is wrong.
Maroka
Quetta, but you know, another
Bolivia Masia.
If you find that people are baptizing children,
Tabaya Huliki mega churches,
you know, that the aim is to get a big church, a mega church,
the choir,
and big choirs
that
are to be there.
Over more Revelation chapter 3.
If you read in Revelation chapter 3,
according
to what God is interpreting, because those things have been written long ago, but there's one that God takes. And he makes it to speak in this
day.
Our Bible says, Christ is outside and he's knocking. And you must realize the prophet says it's because they have taken him outside, they chased him out. Now, others would ask, how did they chase him out? It is the word. They took this word.
In the beginning was the word.
Because from that
word,
they refused that word. They then cannot live the right life. So now they are left with scriptures.
I grew up.
You see?
But
they have
left
the word.
But keep it together.
They are keeping the church together with some activities.
Amen.
Which you can even find outside the church.
Hallelujah.
You know, because what is to keep the people is not there.
So
now you have to come up with something. You know, he looks
and it's like,
you know, this thing they're doing at work, I like it. We must just come and bring it to the church.
But the togetherness.
You know, it's all those, you know, let's come together and all those kind of things. Because it's good when people are coming together. But coming together outside the world, it's a vain gathering.
Amen.
Now, a child of God in this day is able to understand that the main priority is to realize that people have left the word. And it is the same word that has been spoken in the book of Revelation. Not to go to church. And life, your life not changing. If your life is not changing, and there's nothing rebuking you, and you see yourself going back, you should realize something is not right.
Amen.
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 As a child of God, you're supposed to look where God is working.
Alleluia.
So that your things go accordingly.
Amen.
Amen.
So let's
read in the scripture. Now we start to realize that in our days, God has sent a prophet. So he can come and warn this world of the condition of the time. Because people are going from the
world,
just as they were able to come up with Pharisees, leaving what God has spoken in his word, concentrating on what used to be. Even though, you know, in every single age, there is a word being spoken to the people.
It
is supposed to transform a believer and make them a full Christian. Remember, children of God, from the beginning, when you look, the Bible shows that sin has caused a great damage in the soul of a man. God has continuously been sending prophets to the world. Because a man needs a guide at all times. Because there's no point where God can now say this person is complete. When one prophet leaves, you think all these people have heard. But to show that there's something missing.
So deep.
You know, people have gone so deep into a problem. Where one prophet comes and picks them up and puts them to a certain level. And because he's also a man, when his days are finished, he leaves them having not been completed. Then God sends another prophet
to
take these people a bit further until these people are completely out of sin.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the Pharisees didn't think they were still in sin. They were there in the church.
Amen.
Thinking, we have left sin. You know, even having positions in the church. Thinking we are out. We have come out of it. But when Jesus Christ came, he says, woe unto you. When the nation is looking unto them, and you find that the leaders, they themselves have not reached. In the past,
in the Old Testament,
God gave them a way of worshiping. And even over that, he gave them ministers and people to show them how to worship. To show them that when they are doing something, they should do things in which God is in those things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I was speaking with you the other day, saying that if a person is doing something in a place where God is, there is a certain power that comes with that. If a person goes to a river, being going there to just to swim.
You know what watching?
He's just swimming.
Maragata lerena batho ba
Bible. But if he comes with us Bible people to that water.
Asututa.
It's not swimming.
Moro dina lesebe.
We are going to deal with
sin. Rabaratana lena ka mometseng.
We ever go with him.
Tata ba borapedi.
With this matter of worship.
Yena ba thuta mo mabane.
When he was swimming there yesterday.
Ri tsaga di sa tloge.
His sins were not bringing.
Ha kwa lesila modimo.
He was hearing the word. Ha kwa
lena mometseng.
And we come back with him to the water.
That's right. Kabala ke mo modimo a leng gona.
Because that is where God is.
Ke modimo a le ka rataba.
When God is in a matter.
E bolela lutsi dintsi.
It says a lot.
Amen.
It says a lot of things. Amen.
Plan tsa batho.
People, the plans of people.
Tse di kholo.
The big plans.
A di gona le ka ntjwa.
They are not able to be compared.
A small thing.
With a small thing.
Ke modimo e modimo a dira.
That God is doing.
Right. Bale e fa le di komrao.
Now this gospel in the past has been showing, has been visible until the time of Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ ho tla ga le fasting.
The coming of Jesus Christ brought power.
That's what be tshe mo prophet a bolela.
You know, I was looking at what the prophet was saying.
Are ntwe ntwe ile ra re batho ba se ka ba fithela se modimo a se dira.
Saying that what makes people to be unable to realize what God is doing.
A ba gone go amogela the presence ya modimo.
It's because they cannot accept God's presence.
Bale o bolela ka letswalo.
Now he talks about the conscience.
O bolela ka conscience le subconscious.
Amen.
Ya o bolela ka mogao.
The conscience and the subconscious.
Gore o bolela ka gore ge motho a ekwa.
He says when a person hears
lentjwe la modimo.
Hears the word of God.
Le tla mo yena.
Coming to them.
O le tshwara pele ka conscience ya.
They first take that word with their conscience.
Ara marwe motho o agagile gore dilo a ditele ka subconscious.
But a person is built in such a way that they take things with the subconscious.
Ke mo dilo di tshoma o dire ha ho.
And that is where things start to happen.
All right, o bolela ka lentjwe la modimo.
So now he's talking about the word of God.
O re
he says
Bible e lentjwe la modimo la go mo profeta.
The Bible says the word of the Lord went to the prophet.
Ga lentjwe la modimo le ya mo profeta le ha kae mo motho.
But when the word of God goes to that prophet, where in that person does it go?
Gore mo motho o ba le mo profeta.
It says in this person called the prophet.
Modimo o be ntse lentjwe la ke tsa ke conscience le subconscious.
God has these things which he uses called the conscience and the subconscious.
Well, ore ge modimo a di dilo di be kgole le kgole.
And he says when God has made them to be further apart from each other.
Lo lora ka so go lorile mo phelo ba
ga. You won't even have a dream in your life.
Ka ba la go lora
because when you dream
o so nyu tsene ka ra subconscious.
You have to go into your subconscious.
Ba ge di ka kgaogana.
Now if those two are separated
o ka so go lori
you won't even dream.
O tla lokwa batho ba o botsa ditoro.
You hear people telling you about dreams.
Le ba re tora o tsho lo king.
You know, even talking about a dream you
know that subconscious ya go le conscience ya.
Because your subconscious is far from your conscience.
Ge modimo a di batlametse.
But when God brings them close
go la ra ditlo
you are able to now dreams
and ga modimo a ka di tsiya ga ye mo modimo a ye mo.
Now if God can take one and put it over another
well what did Paul
now you are able to see visions.
Amen.
Ga ho mo le di Paul
now you see visions
king tshwe ile ga mara mo
is something that is in a man
la tsona bana ba modimo.
Amen.
Are mo prophet.
He says a prophet
o lora a buti ma
dreams with their eyes open.
Kura aso no robala pele.
So they don't need to fall asleep.
Or as switch from conscious to subconscious.
Switch from the subconscious to the conscious.
No, ingira akamuka.
No, all these things happen.
Or alibeleti awo libeleti.
No, you know when he's looking at you,
parting where had.
One part of him.
Yeah, ya ka ra bophelo ba hao.
Goes into your life.
Yeah, bona dilotse di tlhagile ka ra bophelo ba gao.
And seeing things that has gone and happened in your life. Then some years back but he's looking at you
well the prophet orwele ga motho a lola.
So now the prophet says when a person is dreaming there are certain dreams
wa di gopola le motho o godi
that you can remember even when you grow up.
Are ba gala re o di gopole.
Says the reason you are able to remember
because ka ba gala your part in where how
is because a certain part of you
was somewhere
even le le filo tsuko
well ge o lola.
When you dream
you
know it's not that your dreams are happening right there on the bed.
Well, let's part in where how
some part
yeah somewhere
goes somewhere
yeah you have to yeah bona dilo tse
goes there and sees those
yeah bua
and then it comes back
yeah kamo
and it comes to
you. Yeah, don't switch out from the subconscious to the conscious.
Now, when you switch between the subconscious and the conscious
yeah you will lose that kamo.
Some things just go missing in that transition.
That's why mo prophet are gona le a dreamer.
That's why when the prophet says if there's a dreamer
go no be an interpreter of
dreams. He has to be an interpreter of the dreams.
And motho ka gona o interpreter
toro. And the person who is able to interpret the dream.
Was neng e go switchant. Gore go mmotsa toro.
When you tell that person the dream,
wow, tieleta.
They listen to you.
But
as you are telling the dream, they are able to see that
dream. Well, in the subconscious.
Now there's nothing that's going to be left in the subconscious.
Because
he has all these things here. Now he says the dream can be wrong. Because you see, when you are switching between there's a certain part where this thing is where things go missing. Now God goes to a prophet because he has built him in such a way that the two consciences are close to each other. Now he's able to see through things.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Alright.
Now he says, for you to be able to believe, you are able to hear the word of God and accept it and say, I believe God, there's no way where I'm lacking.
We are at the conscious part.
Now we're talking about the conscious part. Now when God comes to a man,
in the subconscious,
he goes into the subconscious. That is where he goes when he goes
into the subconscious. Your subconscious.
Until your subconscious speaks the very same thing your conscious is speaking, you are unable to believe.
Amen.
The Bible says God is a God of the heart.
Alright, I read this so.
Okay, let's look at it this way. Let's look at it in the terms of the mind.
Yeah, that's right. Conscious mind.
When it's complete, it's called the conscious mind.
And the subconscious mind.
And the subconscious mind. So a person thinks in two levels.
Proverbs.
The way
as a man thinketh in his heart.
As a man thinketh in his heart. Inside the heart of a man.
Faculty,
there is a faculty to think.
The subconscious.
That's where the subconscious works.
Subconscious.
When things have gone into the subconscious, there's no way they cannot happen. Because the laws
are connected in the subconscious.
Amen.
Amen.
Right. How shall we say this? When you're doing something, you know what you have to do.
You tell driver koloi.
Say you learned how to drive a car. And you're looking for a way to go to work. Because you have not been working there for a long time.
So
but after a while, that way is now recorded in your
Now
when you go, sometimes you find yourself going to work. You don't even think about it. You just find yourself having passed a certain point. Because that thing went from the inside. You don't even have questions. Sometimes you even find it's a weekend. And you are on the road going to work. If you make one wrong turn, to go towards the
subconscious side of take over.
Your subconscious takes over. And you'll find yourself entering at the gate. And asking yourself, what am I actually doing here? But now that you won't get lost in someone else's home. Getting in people's houses. And asking yourself, what are we doing here?
We
do that in a place that you are familiar with.
We have office.
You get lost. In an office,
like, oh, office
because that roots to your office planted in your heart.
That's right.
Amen.
But my prophet already.
Now the prophet says, God can listen to you and you're saying, yes, I believe, I believe. But on the inside, if you do not get that part,
that
God is here, God doesn't do anything. Because you do not have faith.
I believe.
On the outside, you can say I
believe.
But until your inside
says it in your conscience
is speaking the same thing as your conscience,
acting.
God cannot act.
Mara ga lintjule ka dira subconscious a le phile.
But now the word that can quicken your subconscious.
Ke lintjula today.
It's today's word.
Le lena li impact le modimo a le
kwente. Which has an impact which God has inspired.
But bible lintjula modimo ka le bogale.
Because the bible says the word of God is sharp.
And it will pull it.
And it pulls through.
Iba ga le khona it pierces through go le peli khaba.
When it pierces through.
Le nena lintjulo idira ka bogale.
It has something that is going to do.
Mara bora ra lintju
but when you're preaching your word
la lintju
yo talking your
let us have le lintselo le letswalo la ha
that does not say anything to your soul
then uba kuka
then where you going to be
e ba tlhogo fela ba tla ba ya ndole
it's just a mental thing that you have
that is why Jesus Christ aitla
that is why when Jesus Christ came
we la tla tsela ya hore dilo di fitla go letswalo la motho
he made a way for things to go into the soul of a man the bible says
ere ba tswa le ba khale
the people of old
Nebane lindo tse ba di dira ma priest ne ba di dira.
They had things that they were doing that the priest would do.
Eh di khabele.
The sacrifices?
Ba le ga o rapelela motho wa o senya.
Trying to pray for someone who has sinned or who has committed wrong.
Amen. Mara bibile re ge Jesu a etla.
Now the Bible says when Jesus came.
Go be go tshwanetse.
It was a fitting.
Gore go fetole mo priest
for the priesthood to change.
Amen.
Uto
amo mo priesteng ba Aaron.
From the priesthood of Aaron.
Go amo mo priesteng ba Melchizedek.
To the priesthood of Melchizedek.
Ke ga ba ga la go change wa priest ba Aaron go ya go Melchizedek.
Why is there a need to change the priesthood from Aaron's priesthood to Melchizedek?
Ka gore di khabelo tene ba di dira.
Because he says the sacrifices that they were making.
Ka fa sa go dire di ba Aaron.
Under the leadership of Aaron.
Di bedisa go no tlatswa letswa.
Were not able to clean the conscience.
Mara ke mo modimanya go bereka le yona o thoma go.
But now that is where God wants to operate in
Amen.
Amen.
Ga le bona. All right, nkani bibile re mo priest ba Aaron.
Okay, why does the Bible says that Aaron's priesthood?
Murimo rumile Moses.
You know God sent Moses.
Na itse batla ba
Moses. You know the matter of Moses?
Ga mo khwabe le re.
The way he was born.
A chaba.
And he really fled.
A yo kwapala le modimo go sekgwe.
Until he met God in the wilderness.
Modimo mo tla ke a o Roma.
And God said I'm sending you.
And then ya kwa go repeta on chaba.
Go there to Egypt and bring people out.
Then Moshe mola ba modima roma yena.
Now God when Moses when God was sending him,
ye le rno na khono bolela.
He said no, I can't speak.
Modima robere ka bangar roma yena.
Now God says now how are you going to work because I'm sending you.
Aro runkile gona a be Aaroni ge.
And then he said okay, it's fine. Let it be
Aaroni.
Let Aaron.
Ya ba o thoma go ba utja karolo ye se jo be dira ke Moshe.
Now Aaron took the part that was supposed to be taken by Moses.
Demoshe asenge ayo bona Pharaoh
when Moses was supposed to see Pharaoh
ki ena na filimat
he was the one given power
mara ga ba le go ile a ba le part yengwe ya se amogele that ministry ka go modimo mo fangone
but because he had a part where he could not accept the ministry the way God gave it he went with Aaron
ya ba everything ye ya mo
and now it was that everything that was going
to the substitute man
go went to the substitute man
mola ile monna wa nnete be ile da o Moshe
whereas the actual man was Moses himself
yole Moshe Aaron ka bo di ready ba hai
now Aaron with his priesthood ministry
Moshe ke ena na ba bolela le modimo
Moses was the one speaking to God
Awale la Israel le modimo
speaking on Israel's behalf to God
mara ga ga la Moshe o bantsa ghetile monna o mongwe
but because Moses has now chosen a person here
ya ba le ge go nyakiwa mo priest
it was that even when the priest was looked for
mola o bosunyo ba tsana Moshe
where Moses was supposed to be
that rebellion na Moses
because he was the Levite
yeah na i go tell you
he didn't feel to
yeah,
go Aaron was now to go
ya ba everything ye ka ngwa no
now everything that was to come
ke substitute
a substitute
the khabele tsa hona
the sacrifice
were
made by substitute
le go diang
where they were going
did you remember what substitute
they were doing a substitute work
magaro ita o modimo a murumetse
but when Amen. Was when God brought the one whom he sent
and as rumeletse o mongwe
and he didn't send one
agira modiro ka boyena
he did the job himself
then ya ba mero ona wa pelela
and then the work was finished
ere because obone ka motho a tswele the power of an endless life
because what was needed was one who had the power of an endless life
gemoshe
when Moses
o nasu ba dinge mereko
was supposed to have done the work
I fika mo felo ba bophelo ba hae
came to the end of his days
are lo And
he said, realize God will send unto you a prophet. Likened unto myself. He says, the thing that I should have done, that man will listen to him. Because Jesus Christ was coming to do the part that Moses didn't. When God said, do this, he said, no, they wouldn't listen to me. When God said, speak to Pharaoh,
he
says, no, I can't speak. God says, but who gave a man mouth? You mean to tell me I didn't know that you were stammering? I called you knowing that you had a stammering tongue. Because with this stammering tongue, you must go and do my work. Now it shows that if the gospel comes to that person who God requires,
the gospel,
it does the work that it's supposed to
do.
Now in our time, the word of God has been spoken, that a prophet will come. He has come.
The interpretation.
That's the interpretation. You know, men with different names can come
but mega churches.
With bigger churches, mega churches. But God, he hasn't spoken to them. And let me tell you something you do not realize. If you're just listening to news, you're not able to realize what's going on. Then we'll be in some trouble. Now, because the devil is after you, he has done a lot of things out there. That when they come to you, it seems like it's just news. But in actual fact, it is a way to surround you. It is a fence. There's some that have started this side.
By bitter end time, what?
Calling themselves an end time something. They are making people to drink paraffin and eat rats and all those sort of things.
Why in the verse they give you?
Why couldn't they come up with another name?
Barbona end time.
They are calling themselves end time.
Because in training end time you said it
never suspect. Because now whatever is being called end time must be suspect.
Training which are doing paraffin, vale na today.
What you call your belief of the day? You are saying how did it come from?
Seven angels.
With seven angels.
I see what they could happen.
Yes, others in
seven angels.
Seven angels. What are they doing?
Because anything
that's going along with this
belief,
he has to come up with things right around.
And the government.
And then the government
is
looking for those people.
It's
looking for these end time people. Because they have wrong things. They are fighting with the police. They are feeding people.
Things.
Why don't they call themselves Catholic something? When they are doing these things of theirs. Why don't they call themselves Pentecostal something? When they are doing these things of theirs.
So
you have to wake up from your sleep.
Amen. That's right.
Amen. Now you see, in the time of Jesus, when he was on the earth, you hear that around that time there were people who came up. One coming with people and killing them in the bush. They were trying to contaminate that which Christ had done.
Today,
now today,
interpretation
of God's word
come out of them.
Is God said, come out of them. That is the word that God is bringing to
life.
A child of God who is set to separate with what God said he does not want. Not because they've been preached where you are praying.
No, Malachi 4.
No, because Malachi 4 has spoken them.
Amen.
Amen.
Malachi 4.
I'm talking about Malachi 4.
Wala wako China wala.
That one in China.
Of Malachi 4.
Of Malachi 4. What do you say of
that? Everything in it swearing.
You know everything that you
have.
You are saying is what the foundation of your faith. The devil takes
it.
Because tomorrow when they come up with a law, there has to be certain key words to which they grab these people with. Amen. Alright, let me close it this way. Child of God, who has heard the word of the day. It is
answering interpretation.
That is the person who has the interpretation of God's word for the day.
Amen.
Power. They have the power
to
resist.
Amen.
That has now attacked this world. They talk. But because they do not have the word of the day, a lot of them, they're speaking all these nice things in church. But when they come out, their life
has
not changed. Because what they have is not the light. So we who have come under this message, we are the ones who have found the message of the light. And the light is what causes things to come to light. But the light of the word is the life of God. When he's bringing things to manifest them. So in every child of God, when they start to live this word, it's not them. It's that light
which you interpret.
That's interpreting itself. Because when God is interpreting his word, he's interpreting it by bringing it to light. When Jesus Christ is speaking, he says, because I live,
Amen.
You live also. How did he live? He was that scripture that was brought to manifestation. Because I live, you live also. Will also be the word that God has spoken in your time.
The prophet, when
he looked, he saw the bride walking in a step, the gospel step. And he saw some looking a bit. And he shouted,
stay back in line.
Stay in line. And they heard. And he came back into the line. Child of God, we could go with the sayings of the times. But if you start following sayings, you'll find yourself without power.
Amen.
Because that is not where God is working. Where God is, that is where he's put his power. That is the word that he's interpreting today. May the Lord God bless you. We are thankful to the children of God. Let us bow our heads. Amen.